Hi, Sam here from Beyond. I wanted to talk you through a few tips about how to use the Beyond pages on the Twinkl website. The first thing that I'm going to show you is the how to set your career so that you get recommendations that are relevant to secondary teachers so that you're able to minimize the amount of primary school related messaging that you might get on the site. And so that it's easier for you, should you choose to subscribe to a secondary only account. Here we go. It's not terribly obvious, but this globe that you can see here on the site, if you click on that, you can then choose change country region. Again, it's not obvious, but when you click on that, you are then given the option to change career as well. So I'm a secondary teacher. I want to get fed secondary teacher recommendations, secondary teacher messaging on the site, and therefore I will choose that and that will update. Now I can do that even before I've signed up to a free subscription, even before I've signed up to a premium subscription. I can do that and the website cookies will remember who I am. Next, how do you get a subscription? Well, you can't get a premium subscription without having got yourself a free subscription to begin with. So first of all, you have to sign up to the website. You have to give yourself a username. You have to give yourself a password. And if you have identified as being a secondary teacher already, then you should be taken to this homepage that you can see in front of you. So this is the Beyond Secondary Resources homepage. If you want to get a subscription, it's fairly straightforward from here. Again, if you've identified yourself as a secondary teacher, when you click membership individual, then you'll be taken through to this page here, and you can choose from a Beyond English subscription, Maths, Science, or the All Secondary one gives you, as suggested, it gives you all of the secondary resources. Now, each of those packages also includes our legacy content that the humanities, the languages, the art, design, and technology legacy content, which are discontinued collections, but they are available should you need to do any cover. What's the best way to navigate on the website? Well, it is a good question. The navigation system is less than ideal on the website, but here's a few ideas. Here's a few ways of finding yourself, finding your way around. So, my favorite go-to, I'm actually an English teacher, so my favorite go-to is the drop-down menu, and I find that via the KS3 and 4 button just by hovering it over it and getting this drop-down menu. And you can see these are our sort of headline categories within English and maths and science, and there are a few other bits and pieces as well, which I'll mention in just a minute. These aren't exclusively the categories we have, so you can see that this KS3 English full collection, that is the sort of the heading category for Key Stage 3. We've got here reading, writing, assessment, curriculum, map, but if we click into it, then we get even more options down the left-hand side here. Now, I'm an English teacher. I know the Key Stage 3 curriculum already, and therefore it's fairly straightforward for me to navigate through these menus then. Right, well, I want a reading comprehension, so I can go through reading. Okay, reading skills is comprehension, and then you come to the reading comprehension. So it's fairly straightforward if you know your curriculum. It's a little bit trickier if you don't, because then you might have to rely on the search function. And the search function on site is less than ideal, let's say. It will sometimes return you exactly what you're looking for. Sometimes it won't, and it'll be a bit more of a search. There's a couple of ways around that. You can get in touch with our Twinkl Cares team and say, I'm looking for this resource, or I'm looking for a resource that does this. Can you give me some help? And they'll be able to offer pointers. You can also Google search it, and the Google search crawl is actually very effective. It probably finds resources on our website better than the website does itself. So that's another way of finding what you're after. Do get in touch though, because we're very happy to point you in the right direction. What else have we got? Well, let me take you back to what I described as my favorite navigation tool, the drop-down menu from the Keystone 3, 4 button. And let me point you towards this. On the right-hand side, you can see Teacher Toolbox. The Teacher Toolbox is an amazing collection of all sorts of other resources that will enable you to that make your life a little bit smoother as you go along with your teaching. So there are form tutor resources in here, there is career content in here, corridor displays, and you can see all of those headings there. We particularly like this festivals and events category because this is where we stockpile all of the relevant festival content as it comes by through the year, and we keep on adding to this, we keep on building on this. At the time I'm recording, it's Pride Month, and if you click into Pride Month, you can see all of our latest content for Pride Month. And this is all collected from English, from maths, from science, all collected in one place, so you can access it all as you wish. What else is there in this menu? Well, we're dead excited about our brand new product, Relationship and Sex Education, and that's available on this menu, drop down on the right-hand side, as you saw. And we are building up our collection for Relationship Sex Education right here. That's available, and that's available whether you're an English teacher, maths, science, whatever you teach, this is available. It's very likely that many teachers are going to find, that many non-specialists are going to find that they're going to have to be talking about these RSE things as we go forward. So it's worth having these in your back pocket. Finally, the other thing that I was going to mention from this drop-down menu was our Beyond Debate. It's here on the left-hand side. Now, Beyond Debate, I've just clicked onto it, but I'm going to click back onto this big button here, KS3 and 4. When I click the button itself, it takes me to the secondary homepage, the Beyond homepage. The Beyond Debate appears in this big purple banner box at the top of the page, and we change the debate every week. So there's a new question every week. It's designed so that you can keep your students occupied during form times. It's designed to stretch speaking and listening skills, but also give students a chance to talk about topical issues, things that are in the news right now that we think is important that young people should be able to be expressing their views upon. So that's available as well, again, to English, maths, science teachers. You can either click into it this way, view the resources. So it's a question. You can just talk about the question. You can make the question big on your screens, or you can download the pack here and you can actually use the materials in here to really dive into the debate. You can access it that way, like I say. Equally, you can access it on this menu, and then you can see all of the previous packs that we have used as well. So the one that you saw on the homepage is the BBC license fee one, but there are, I don't want to say hundreds because there's not hundreds, but there are many, many debate packs which you can also access. Like I say, they're available to everyone who has a subscription on the Twinkl website. I hope that's helpful to you. Thanks for watching. If you're watching this on YouTube, subscribe, like, and I hope to see you round. Goodbye for now.